In this video, we'll discuss about capacitance type liquid load measurement technique. So capacitance type technique is having advantage, like it's widely used. It can be used for both the conducting and non-conducting materials. It is having no moving parts. So what is the level measurement? If you define it, so it's simply determining the position of a surface inside a tank, reactor or any other vessel. And if you define precisely, it's basically a determination of linear vertical distance between a reference point. What is this reference point? Where you locate your sensor and it to the surface of either a liquid or top of a solid or interface of two liquids. And precise control of this level of liquid in a tank, reactor or any other vessel is important in many process control applications. So and this level control or level measurement is required for maintaining inventory. So in industries where lot of raw materials has to be stored for achieving your production targets, for that inventory management level measurement is required. Custody transfer: whenever the material is purchased or sold, it can be done based on level measurement. Storage efficiency: if you see in the right side tank, so the liquid is not 100% stored. If you use a proper level measurement technique, so it can be stored 100%, it will be increases your storage efficiency. And another one is safety. So to prevent these spillages, so level measurement is required. So before going to discuss in detail, so we'll discuss some of the basics of the capacitor. So what is basically a capacitor? Capacitor consists of two plates, metal plates, that is separated by a dielectric material. And the capacitance of this capacitor is given by C equal to epsilon A by D, which is given by epsilon naught into epsilon R into A by D, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space, whose value is as 8.85 × 10⁻¹² farad per meter, and epsilon naught is the relative permittivity of the material. It is also known as dielectric constant, and A is the area of the plate and D is the distance between the plate. So any of these parameters, that is dielectric constant or area or distance between the plates, if you vary, so the capacitance is varied. So by measuring the capacitance, so any of these variations can be measured. So this capacitance type level sensor can be used for the measurement of both conducting and non-conducting liquids. So for non-conducting liquids, so the measuring varying parameter is the dielectric constant, and for conducting liquids, it's the mainly the distance between the plates is the measuring parameter. So what is a dielectric? Dielectric material, so it's a substance with very low electrical conductivity, that is, it's basically an insulator. So the dielectric constant or relative permittivity is the value that will determine measure the effectiveness of your dielectric material. Means higher the dielectric constant, so the amount of energy that can be stored in the material will be the high. So among the more common solid dielectrics are glass, rubber, wood, etc. Liquid dielectrics include hydrocarbon oil, silicon oils, etc. And the standard measurements of this dielectric constant for various materials at 20 degrees centigrade, if you see, so it is having 1.0058. This is with respect to the vacuum of dielectric constant 1, and benzene, so if you see 2.31, and glycerol 51, and water is having a dielectric constant of 81. So and this is the capacitance of two concentric cylinders. So in industries where we are using the capacitance, they are generally of concentric cylinder type. So and the capacitance of these concentric cylinders is given by, so where C equal to 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon R into L by L natural logarithm of R2 by R1, where L is the overlapping distance, overlapping area of overlapping length of the two electrodes. So if any outer electrode or inner electrode moves in opposite directions, so the L decreases. And similarly, R2 is the inner radius of the outer cylinder, and R1 is the outer radius of the inner cylinder. And this is the capacitance which we are going to use for this capacitance type liquid measurement sensors. and all liquids with conductivity greater than 10 microsiemens per centimeter are considered as conductive. So unit of conductivity is siemens, or it can be specified as a mho. Also, all strongly corroding acids aqueous solutions are conducting. If the liquid wets the electrode, it can lead to an erroneous signal. So this is one of the problem with the capacitive type liquid sensor. So whenever we are measuring any conductive level of a conducting liquids, so this when in the problem will occur whenever this conducting material coated on the electrode. So there is some counter measures you have to take to eliminate this effect. Liquids with conductivity less than 0.1 microsiemens per centimeter is termed as insulating. All hydrocarbons, solvents, vegetable oils, petroleum based products are of this category, means they are non-conducting. So in all capacitive level measurement, the tank or the outer electrode is grounded to avoid any stray capacitance, means to prevent the error, so it should be grounded. So this is the measurement for non-conducting liquids. So these are two concentric cylindrical electrodes. We can see here 2R2 is the inner radius, inner diameter of the outer cylinder. So and 2R1 is the outer diameter of the inner cylinder. And H1 and epsilon 1 are the height of the liquid and relative permittivity of the liquid, and whereas H2 and epsilon 2 are the height of the cylinder above the liquid level and relative permittivity of the vapor or air above that liquid level. If you see here, the varying parameter here is the dielectric constant. So there is a space between in the downside for entering the liquid inside between these two cylinders. So as the liquid level rises, so the H1 increases. So that if you see, the effective capacitance will change, which is given by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 H1 plus epsilon 2 into H2. Here, whenever the H1 rises, the capacitance will increase because the dielectric constant of the liquid is very high compared to that of the air or vapor. This is for non-conducting liquids. And this is the measurement of the liquid level of conducting liquids. Here this is a conducting liquid, so the there is a rod type electrode, so which is here you can see that, and surrounding that there is a dielectric coating which is acting as an insulator. Here the dielectric constant is throughout the electrode is constant, so the here the dielectric constant is not changing. Here what is changing? The surrounding conducting liquid around your dielectric coating will change, so which will change the overlapping length of your concentric cylinders. Here the varying parameter is L, so whenever the liquid level changes, so the overlapping length of your concentric cylinder L will change, means here L will increase. So whenever liquid is increasing, liquid level is going high, it will L will decrease whenever liquid level is going high. So this will having a direct effect on the capacitance by using the relation C equal to 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon R into L by L log one natural logarithm of R2 by R1, where R1 is the radius of the inner rod and R2 is the radius of the rod with the sheath. Means itself mainly because due to that of your conducting liquid. So there is a problem with your capacitance type liquid level measurement whenever you are measuring conducting liquids, which can coat on your insulation and it will give an erroneous signal. So in order to eliminate that problem, so we have to use RF admittance level measurement techniques. So in RF admittance level measurement technique, in addition to measuring capacitance, it will also measure the conductivity, that is also known as inversely proportional to a capacitance reactance or impedance. So which is given by 1 by 2 pi f into c, where f is the frequency of operation of your capacitance, that is your level sensor. So whenever there is a conductive coating on the probe, here you can see there is a coating. So a non-RF unit means if you use a normal capacitance based technique, so will indicate the level at the top of the coating, because it will measure the only the capacitance, and it will this coating will increase the capacitance, so and it will use an erroneous reading. So in order to overcome this effect, RF admittance level measurement will measure impedance in addition to the capacitance. So at the actual level, the amount of capacitor reactance, that is impedance, is low because the space between the tank wall and the probe is filled with a conductive liquid. Here you can see it is a conductive liquid, so the impedance is less. However, at the coating, so even though the capacitance is showing high because of this coating, so there is a large air space between the probe and the tank wall. So this air space results in high amount of capacitor reactance, and the electronic circuitry will measure this high impedance in the coating area, and it will counteract this error caused due to this coating, which will increase your capacitance value. Thank you for watching my video.